10th standard, CBSE board 10th standard, NCERT syllabus, chapter number 1, life process. And in that life process, we are going to deal with the first part, that is nutrition. So let's start our topic, nutrition. Nutrition is the component which is necessary for the growth and development of the body. So हमारे body के growth and development के लिए जो component की आवश्यकता होती है, हम उसे कहते हैं nutrition. So nutrition का definition है हम यहाँ में देते हैं. So it is a component. It is a component which is necessary for our body to function and also requires for the growth and development. So this is nutrition. So what are the types of nutrition? We have two major types of nutrition. One is autotrophic nutrition, and second one is heterotrophic nutrition. So there are two types, and apart from these two types, we have various subtypes. So let us understand what this autotrophic nutrition is. First one, autotrophic nutrition. Auto means self. So it means the nutrition which we have to synthesize by your own is known as autotrophic nutrition. And hetero means others. So hetero means heterotrophic, in which hetero means others. So this type of nutrition can be synthesized by the others. So it cannot be synthesized by your own. It has to be synthesized from other sources. For example, animals. So animals are a type of heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Autotroph, plants are autotroph, which they synthesize their food with the help of photosynthesis, and heterotrophs like animals. So we depend on others. So we come under the category heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So let us classify or simplify all the types of nutrition so that we can understand the entire types in one slide, right? Okay. So nutrition can be divided. We know that it is divided into two types, right? One is autotrophic nutrition, and second one is heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic and heterotrophic nutrition. In autotroph is again divided into two types. One is photoautotrophic, and second one is chemoautotrophic. So autotrophic nutrition is divided into autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Autotrophic is again divided into photoautotrophic and chemoautotroph. So this word photo means light. So this type of nutrition is depend on light. This is light dependent. So the nutrition which is light dependent or known as phototrophic mode of nutrition, and chemo indicates chemical. So the nutrition which depends upon light is known as photoautotrophic mode of nutrition. The nutrition which depends on chemical substances are chemoautotrophic mode of nutrition, right? So this is two type of autotrophic nutrition. Now heterotrophic. So there are various type of heterotrophic mode of nutrition. One heterotrophic mode of nutrition is heterotrophic mode of nutrition means heteros means others. So the nutrition which which depends on others. So the nutrition which we get from other sources is known as heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So first one is saprophytic mode of nutrition. In heterotroph we have saprophytic mode of nutrition. Second one is parasitic mode of nutrition. Parasitic mode of nutrition. And third one is holozoic mode of nutrition. Third one is holozoic mode of nutrition. So we have nutrition divided into autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. In autotrophic, we have photoautotrophic and we have chemoautotrophic. Photoautotrophic means the autotrophic mode of nutrition which depends on light, and chemoautotrophic means the autotrophic mode of nutrition which depends on chemical substances. So two types: heterotrophic, heteros means others, so it depends on other sources. In that, first type is saprophytic, second type is parasitic, and third type is holozoic. What is saprophytic? So saprophytic means the organism, the type of the mode of nutrition which we get from the dead remains. That type of, which means the organism which absorb or which take their nutrition from the dead remains are termed as saprophytic mode of nutrition. Parasitic mode of nutrition, parasites are of two types. One is ectoparasites and endoparasites. So parasitic mode of nutrition, which means the nutrition which organism take from the host body without entering or by entering inside the host body. So from the host body, if we take the nutrition, that kind of nutrition is parasitic mode of nutrition. And if we get from the dead remains, it is saprophytic mode of nutrition. What is holozoic? So holo, which means as a whole, as a complex material. So the nutrition which we get as a whole and then we break inside the host body, inside our whole body, that type of nutrition is holozoic mode of nutrition. So we can say human body or animal body, most of the animal body, they are holozoic. Holozoic means we take complex food material, we break down into small molecules, and then in our body it gets absorbed and reaches to the different parts of the cell. So this is the simple classification of nutrition. Okay, so let us classify the entire nutrition and with some examples. So nutrition is classified into two category. We already saw that autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Autotrophic, the nutrition, the organism which belong to this category, autotrophic, which means which they synthesize their own food, are termed as autotrophs, and the organism which is depends on others are termed as heterotrophs. Heteros means others, auto means itself. So autotrophic mode of nutrition are subdivided into two types: photoautotrophic and chemoautotrophic. Photoautotrophic, example green plants and euglena, which means they synthesize their own food with the help of light, photo. Chemoautotrophic, example fungal bacteria and nitrate bacteria, which means they synthesize their own food with the help of some chemical components. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition, heterotrophic are of three types: saprotrophic, parasitic, and holozoic. So saprotrophic mode of nutrition, example bacteria, fungi, etc. Parasitic mode of nutrition, they are again divided into ectoparasites and endoparasites. So ecto means out and endo means in. So ecto means outside and endo means inside, which means the parasites which retrieve their nutrition or which get their nutrition outside the body, from outside the body, are known as ectoparasites. That example lice, leech, we can say lice. Lice, which means it's something, it's a small organism, some parasites which present on most of the human beings or animals. Parasitic, endoparasites, example ascaris. Then we have holozoic, third type, holozoic. And holozoic means the organism which consume their food from others, but as a whole material, then directly it is broken down inside the body and then it absorbed. And most of the animals, they follow holozoic types. So they comes in the category holozoic. So this is two type of nutrition. So organism which follow photoautotrophic are green plants, and the process is photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, which we'll see later. Chemoautotrophic, then we have a chemoautotrophic organism which synthesize their food with the help of photosynthesis are called phototrophs, and organisms which synthesize their food with the help of chemical components are called chemoautotrophs. Chemoautotrophs. And the saprophytic mode of nutrition, the organisms which are under the saprophytic mode of nutrition, they are called saprotrophs. The organisms which undergo parasitic mode of nutrition, they are called parasites. And holozoic, we all animals come under holozoic mode of nutrition. Thank you. So that's all about the nutrition part. I hope you liked it. If you liked the video,